Discovery Kids! Welcome back to Passport to Adventure. Can you believe how quickly this week has been going? It's just been flying by. Wow. Today we're going to look at Colossians 3:13 through 14, which says, bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you have a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them together in perfect unity. Colossians 3:13-14. Well, today our travels take us to the Czech Republic. You look pretty dapper there, Miss Tony.
Thank you.
We will meet some very special people, the Pardos. They are Calvary missionaries there. And then we'll jump back to the Bible times and we'll see Jesus and how he forgave us of our sin and offers us the greatest love. And we'll hear that through the gospel message. Well, let's get started. Let's get our passports out one more time.
So I've got my passport.
All right, let's get our Bible.
Yep,
let's get that Bible. All right, well, we are going to bow our heads, quiet our hearts, and fold our hands. Lord God, thank you for another great day at VBS where we can learn more about you. Thank you for your love and your forgiveness. I pray for each child here in VBS today that they will know your free gift of salvation. I pray for young hearts today as we share the gospel. We pray a special blessing on the Pardos as they share your love with the Czech people. Thank you that you love us so much and that you do have the whole world in your hands and you hold us oh so tight. And all God's children said,
Amen.
Well, check out the Facebook group to see how our Feed New Mexico food collection is going. Do you think we're going to get to be 1 ton?
I think so.
And remember, 1 ton equals an elephant. That's so fun to think about. So drop off your food at the Calvary Collection Center at the Osuna drive-thru this weekend to be counted for the VBS Mission Project. Okay, Tony, can you do our memory verse for us?
All right.
Colossians 3:12 through 14.
All right, 3:12 through 14. Okay, here we go, boys and girls. Colossians 3:12 through 14. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all of these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity.
Awesome, Tony. Thank you. All right, you guys, are you ready for some worship?
Let's worship.
Dawn of creation, this world has been crying out for hope, for a hero to save us. We long for the supernatural.
But there is only one God who can save the day. So clear the stage, prepare the way, 'cause heaven and earth are singing. Glory, hallelujah. Let the whole world see the greatness of our God. In awesome wonder, he reigns forever. We know the greatness of our God. His power is endless. He lives within us. We know the greatness of our God.
right, guys. So today is Friday. We've gone all week learning our Bible virtues, and today is love and forgiveness. So on our next set, we're going to go through all the Bible virtues. So I want you guys to think about what you've been learning all week from that Bible verse, and we're going to go through it. So let's end in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you that you have the whole world in your hand, that you are great, God, that we know that wherever we go, that you are with us, Lord. Help us to have fun today, but help us to remember all those Bible virtues so that when we come back and worship together, that we can shout them out with you. It's in Jesus' precious and holy name we pray. And everybody said, amen.
The pretty castles on the way on the plane?
How could I miss it? You screamed every single time we saw a castle. How long was that flight?
I think it was like 7 or 8 hours.
How can you guys be tired? We're in the land of princes and princesses.
It's not really like that anymore.
I mean, but like imagine back then, like with all the long pretty gowns and balls and like the big castles that are freshly built.
Your Majesty would have enjoyed that a lot.
I should have been a princess. Thank you, Taylor.
Well, hello, ladies. Welcome to the Hollywood Hotel. Anything I can help you with?
I'm stealing this couch.
No, I don't think that's...
She's just tired. It's okay.
Oh, okay. Is that Rembrandt?
Cassidy,
oh my
go!
God. And the dining room! The forks are on the wrong side! Let me fix that.
Out, out, out. We're planning an important event and you're ruining it.
I was only trying to help and you had the forks on the wrong side. Just saying.
And then you broke our fruit bowl.
That fruit bowl was too fragile. I was helping you out.
Cassidy, honey, why don't you just stay here?
Maybe if you use super glue to fix the bowl, they'll be happy with you again.
Taylor, that's a great idea. Let me go find some.
No! Cassidy, stay here.
Fine. Okay, you know what? I think it's best if I just give you the room keys now and get you out of here. But if you need anything else, is there anything, just ask me.
Actually, do you know of any tourist locations we can go to?
Oh, yes. Well, we are well known for our historic center of Prague, where they have amazing snacks and as well as amazing crafts as well. Snacks? Can I have chocolate?
Thank you very much, ma'am. Oh. I think that'll be all for today.
My pleasure. If you need anything else, just let me know.
Of course. Now, girls, listen, we have to head to the IMA first before we go on, like, tourist destinations.
No, it's fine. We'll visit our friends, find them, and then go touristing.
Well, let me see where the IMA is at first. It might not be too far from there. Wait a second, it says it's just a little south of Prague. Perfect, that would be on the way.
Meaning I can go get snacks and maybe chocolate.
I heard if you have enough of those, you can turn into a sugar plum fairy.
Cassidy, yes, we can get snacks. Taylor, no.
Listen,
we're headed off to our last destination, so anything you need to pack, let's get ready and let's go, because we have one more journal to find. Ready?
Yes, let's go.
Come on.
I'm up.
Let's go.
Oh, look, it's the Rembrandt painting again.
Oh, my phone is ringing. I think it's my friend. Hi. She hung up or the line was cut.
Guys, look.
I don't know what's next.
Oh, I dropped one. Oh. Well, so basically, here, do you want some?
I'll take a fruit roll up. Thank you.
Thank you.
So basically, when I went to the store to get some candy and snacks and stuff, there was a lady there, and I told her about our mission and what we've been doing and traveling around the world for the whole entire summer. And basically, she gave me this journal saying it was my aunt's, and because she left it, and she was like, well, she was here like a couple days ago, And she left her journal here, and I was planning on giving it to her and stuff like that. Like, she was saying stuff like that. And so I have a letter and I have a journal and cookies.
Wait, just a couple days ago? That means they're still pretty close by, right?
Hey, that's why I'm calling through for a bit. They must be in the region.
Of course. Wait, maybe if we read the letters in the journals, we'll have an idea of where they've been working at, and we can start from there.
Okay.
Okay, so the missionary letter is from my mom. She says, we've been working with the kiddos here as much as we can. Now we're getting them all their supplies and stuff, but we've mainly been focusing on teaching them the gospel. Now this country is 70 to 80% atheist, so most of these kids don't even have an idea of who Jesus is. Oh, wow. So we've started off teaching them the Bible verse, Colossians 3:12, which we've been teaching to all the kids across all the countries. And we've also taught them a new shout out. Jesus loves you, put on love and forgiveness. Now that goes along with the salvation story, which we got to, for the very first time, teach these kids. Wow, that's really cool. But it doesn't say where they've been at, but there is a QR code here.
Oh, here, I got it.
Hi, I'm Servi.
Hi, I'm Moises.
Hi, I'm Judah.
Hi, I'm Shemuel.
Hi, I'm Maria, and we're the Pardo family, and we're serving as missionaries sent by Calvary Church to Prague, Czech Republic. One challenge we had is that a lot of people here, they don't know who God is, they don't believe in any God, and to them, the stories from the Bible are like fairy tales. So that makes it really challenging to share with them and tell them something as simple as Jesus loves you when they don't even know who it is we're talking about. So something we've found that really works for us here as missionaries is to build relationships with people. And what that means is we're building friendships. We're making friends with people in our own community, our neighbors, people we meet, and using the talents that God's given us so that we can share with other people that Jesus loves them. Our hope is that as we continue to get closer to people and have friendships, and they begin to ask us questions, we can share with them and have that trust built so that they understand what it is to have faith and to believe in God. Prague is a really big city, full of over a million people. But as we mentioned before, there's very few Christians here. In the entire country of Czech Republic, less than 2% of the population would say they have the kind of faith that we do. We meet with a group of local believers and have church together here. We study the Bible, pray together, discuss what it means to live the Bible, and also fellowship with one another in parks or in homes or at our church gatherings. Since there aren't many Christians here, much of our missionary work is spent out in community around us. For Servi, he plays drums, and he gathers with other musicians to grow friendships with them. This has provided a unique opportunity for him to be able to share his faith and his life with others to build trust so that they too can hear the message that Jesus loves them. I, Maria, am an artist. So for me, I've been building relationships within a community of other artists here. Sometimes I've taught lessons or had an art show, and the hope is that within these friendships, as I hear their stories, I can share Jesus' story with them. Czech Republic is really a dark place spiritually, but we remember the words that Jesus said, "Let your light shine before others, so they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Our whole family is involved in this mission. We invite people into our lives so that we can represent Jesus and share God's good news with them. Whether it's through meals in our home, going out in the park, after-school activities, or even studying the Czech language, these are all ways that we as a family are learning to communicate better God's love to the people here in Prague. You too have unique talents, abilities, and a special place that God has put you to live in where you can be a representative of Christ and share His light and love within your neighborhood, within your family, your schools, and your community. We ask that you would also pray for us, that we as a family would be a good example within our community of Jesus, and that we would have patience as we grow trust and share our faith with the friends in our community. Thank you. God bless.
Wow.
It seems like they need the salvation story the most in this area.
I know. Well, I'm really glad our friends are here helping.
Maybe we should read the journal.
Okay, you get that. Here. Okay.
Let's read it.
Let's see. Let me find where they're reading from. Journal entry 714.
Right here. These kids sit here today hardly know anything about Jesus. And when I mention his name, they just stare blankly as if they never heard of him before. I forget some places barely are taught the gospel. Back home, most people have the opportunity to hear about the love of God. But here is different. So we started off with the most important story of the whole Bible, the salvation story.
This is the story of God. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. God created man in his own image, and God saw everything that he had made, and it was very good. God placed man in a garden and told him not to eat from a certain tree. But man disobeyed God's command. And sin came into the world through Adam, and death through sin. And so death spread to all men because all sinned. But God loved man and made a plan. Man would make a sacrifice to cover his sins. But this was only temporary and was not the perfect sacrifice. Jesus, God's Son, came from heaven as a baby, born to a virgin mother in a humble stable, and lived a perfect life. He kept God's commands and loved and helped people. Jesus came to be the true sacrifice for the whole world. Jesus gave his life by dying on the cross to become the perfect sacrifice, to pay the price for our sins. God showed his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Jesus died, was buried, and 3 days later rose from the grave. Jesus ascended to heaven and will one day come again.
I want these kids to know who Jesus truly is. So we will tell him this part of history, and they were amazed. We have had several kids already receive Christ into their hearts, and they all have to do is pray a simple prayer. Guys, I've never actually prayed this prayer. Like, I know Jesus well, but not that well. Will you guys pray it with me? I want to change my life.
Yeah.
Yes.
Of course.
Okay.
Dear Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner, and I want to believe more of you, Lord. I want to have a relationship with you, Lord. I know that I have sinned and done wrong. Please forgive me. In Jesus' name. Amen.
This is so awesome, Good job, Cassidy.
Thank you.
We're so excited for you. Welcome to the family of God.
I feel amazing. I can't wait to tell Aunt Jenna about this.
She's going to be so excited.
I know. But we have to find her first.
Wasn't there a little bit left of the journal?
Oh, I think there was. I can't believe I just threw it down here. Let's see. Let's see. Oh, there is a bit left of the journal. We are off to Prague again to see the historic center of Prague. It's so pretty there, and we wanted a taste of the culture. See you all again later. They're going to Prague!
Hey, that's where we are headed!
Perfect. Oh, wait, I'm getting a call. Mom? Mom? Wait a minute, where are you? We've been looking for you everywhere. Wait, hold on. I'm going to put you on speakerphone. Yeah, okay, go ahead. Say hi to my friends.
Hi, Olivia's mom.
Hi.
Oh, well, hello there. Nice to meet you all. I'm Olivia's mom. What did you guys say your names were?
Taylor.
I'm Cassidy.
Taylor and Cassidy. Wait a minute. Taylor, you have a friend on this mission trip, right? And Cassidy, your Aunt Jenna is here.
Yes.
Yeah, that's us.
Oh, they talk about you guys all the time. Where are you all at?
We're actually here in the Czech Republic.
We are. We're just a little bit away from the city of Prague. Where are you at?
No, really, we aren't too many miles away from that city.
Oh, meet you at the historic center?
Yes, that'd be perfect. We were on our way there exactly. How did you know?
Okay. Awesome! Sounds great!
I can't wait to see you, Mom. We've been waiting to see you forever.
Oh, that's wonderful, sweetie. I can't wait to see you again. See you in 15 minutes.
Okay, fine. Okay, let's get going.
This way.
Tori, Cassidy, your snacks?
Hello, girls. I trust you had a really good day today.
We had an awesome day. It was so good. Cassidy brought snacks, and then I found my friend. She found her mom. She found her aunt, and it was great because after that, we found a bunch of all these tourist locations, and we picked up a bunch of snacks, a bunch of things to put in, like little bunch of souvenirs. But I don't know where I'm gonna put all the souvenirs because I've been collecting souvenirs over the past like few days, and I'm like, I don't know where I'm gonna put all this in my luggage all the way to go back home. So I think I'm gonna have to let go of my cowboy hat, but that's okay because I think I'll buy another cowboy hat on at home online. But it's fine. It's fine because what matters at the end of the day is that we found our loved ones.
Well, that's great to hear. And you know what? I was right. You guys had a great day today.
Hey, you look really familiar.
No, I don't. What are you talking about? I've never seen you before in my life.
No, you keep saying that you have twins and sisters, but sisters don't look this alike.
We're all quadruplets.
Are you wearing a wig? Just as I suspected. Imposter.
Okay, you got me. All right. Yes, I was following you, but it was because I wanted to make sure you guys were safe. There's some dangerous parts in the world, okay? Plus, I have a sister who works with the IMA, and I recently lost contact with her. So, when I found out that there were other people looking for similar people, I just had to follow.
Well, you know they're back at the city, just a couple miles from here.
Really?
You could go see your sister. We can watch the front desk for you if you'd
totally.
Like.
thank you for the offer, but I think I'll just go ahead and have some of my staff put to work here, and I'll put them in charge.
Don't touch.
I'm sorry.
Well, needless to say, I really enjoyed your chain of hotels. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. We've enjoyed our stay very much. Girls, we gotta get packing. We're gonna head to the airport now and meet our friends.
Okay.
Bye.
Up to Aunt Jenna and her cookies!
Hi, guys. I hope you enjoyed your stay at the Hollywood Hotel in the Czech Republic. And before you go, let's go ahead and do our shout out and our Bible verse, okay? And today we have some things are a bit different, so go ahead and pay close attention, okay? So today our shout out is Jesus loves you, put on forgiveness and love, okay? So I'm going to say it and you can repeat after me. Ready? Jesus loves you. Put on forgiveness and love. Good job. Okay, let's go ahead and do our Bible verse that we've been learning throughout this whole entire week. Go ahead and get your hands ready to follow along with the motions. Let's go ahead and do this. Ready? Colossians 3:12. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Good job, guys. Okay, so the way that it's going to be different today is I'm actually going to talk about the verse that comes after that one, verse 13. And that ties in with what we're talking about today. We were talking about forgiveness and love and how Jesus forgave us and he loved us so much that he went and he died on the cross for us. So the other verse talks about all the other things that we've been learning about through the whole entire week, which was compassion, humility, kindness, and patience. So today, forgiveness and love, it comes from verse 13. So I'm going to go ahead and tell you what verse 13 says, all right? Verse 13 says, bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And that just shows how much Jesus loved us. So much that he died on the cross to take away our sins so that we could be with him and God forever. And I really hope and I pray that maybe some of you have learned more about Jesus and want to accept him and into your heart today. All right, guys, and I just want to remind you, don't forget to donate non-perishable food items here to our campus for Feed New Mexico Kids so that we can feed other kids in our city, okay? And also do not forget about our other activities that we have, which include our snack, our missions, and other activities, okay? All right, let's go ahead and close out. And I just want to say that I had a lot of fun with you guys, all of us did this week. And we just love doing these things for you guys to just be able to teach you so much about how much God loves you. Okay? Let's go ahead and put our hands together, bow our heads, and close our eyes. Dear Lord, I thank you for this week, this amazing, wonderful VBS week. I thank you that we were able to still have so much fun even throughout this whole situation that's going on around the whole entire world. And I thank you for every single one of these children that have been able to watch. And I pray that you just touch their little hearts. And I pray that they go out after this and not only just practicing for this week, but even after this week, that they still practice their compassion, love, and forgiveness, humility, gentleness, and patience, and especially the forgiveness and love that they are able to show others because you first loved us and you first forgave us. I pray that you just keep everybody safe, and I pray that everybody has just such a wonderful summer. We love you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. We really hope you guys have an awesome summer, okay? We're gonna miss you. Bye.
Well, I sweat in the heat of the battle, and I fought through the dust and the shadows. Oh, you never left my side, never left my side, no. And I stood at the top of the world, I swam through the depths of my soul. No matter what I find, no matter what I find, oh. Drought or famine, high and low, wherever I go. all the pieces together. You bring me strength in the desert. Oh, you defend my soul. You defend my soul. No height, no depth, no grave. Nothing on earth could keep you away. Oh, you're my only hope. You're my only hope. Life and death, this truth I know. Wherever I go, oh, you're gonna find me there. Wherever I go, oh, you're right beside me there. In the rising flame, even in the pouring rain, even in the flood, I'm safe. Oh, cause you go wherever I go. God in heaven, heard my plea.
Worshiping. Today was my favorite day. We heard about God's plan of forgiveness for our sins and how much Jesus loves us. History is the best story ever told. If you ask Jesus into your heart today, please let us know on our Facebook group. We have a special gift we want to give to you. Also, we want to remind you to come to Calvary Kids and be a part of God's family. We look forward to seeing you. But right now, let's welcome on the rest of the worship team to the stage so they can help us with their shout outs. Come on, guys.
Yay. All right, guys. So we've been learning these virtues all week. We're going to practice them here at the close. So remember the Bible shout out is Jesus loves you. And then we say what the virtue is, put on. So for Monday, it was compassion and kindness. Let's do it together. Jesus loves you. Put on compassion and kindness. Good. Tuesday was humility. Jesus loves you, put on humility. Wednesday was gentleness. Jesus loves you, put on
gentleness.
Thursday, patience. Jesus loves you, put on
patience.
All right. And today was forgiveness and love. Jesus loves you, put on forgiveness and love. But wait a second. I have the love shirt, and I don't think anybody, our team, has forgiveness. God, that's right. So we'll say the Bible verse because we remember that God is the ultimate forgiver, and we learned that today in our gospel message. So let's do it together. Jesus loves you.
Put on forgiveness and love.
All right, guys. We're so happy you got to worship with us this year. So let's put our hands together and close in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this year's VBS. Thank you for all of the new things that we learned and the fun that we had, and help us to go about our next few months with these new virtues, Lord, that you've instilled in our hearts. Thank you for loving us, and it's in Jesus' precious and holy name we pray. Amen. We'll see you guys next year.